In this video, we'll go for the generation model, that is one dimensional steady state heat conduction with internal heat generation. For steady state, we have dT by dT equal to zero. And when we say internal heat generation is present, means that the value of Q triple dash, which is normally expressed as watt per meter cube, is also present. So we have a governing equation here, 1 upon R to the power N del del R, R to the power N del T by del R plus Q triple dash by K equal to 1 by alpha dT by dT rate of change of temperature with respect to time. Alpha is thermal diffusivity. N equal to 0, replace R by X. We have a slab equation. N equal to 1 is for cylinder and N equal to 2 is for sphere. So first of all, we'll discuss the slab. So we replace N equal to 0 and R is equal to X. So this term become 1. This term also become 1. This will become del del X. This has become del T by del X. So you left with del del X of del T by del X. Our steady state equation, we have a model of steady state. So last term will be 0. This term is present plus Q triple dash by K equal to 0. So we have variation of temperature in one direction only. So we write total derivative as d square T by dx square equal to minus Q triple dash by K. So we integrate this. This is the governing equation for slab. So if we integrate, we get dT by dx equals to minus Q triple dash x by K plus some constant C1. We again integrate this. So we get T equal to minus Q triple dash x square by twice K plus C1x plus C2. Now we have two unknowns here. One is C1 and one is C2. But important thing is that temperature is proportional to minus of x square. So whenever we have an internal heat generation, we have a parabolic distribution and parabola is always downward. Remember, y equal to a0 plus a1x is a linear equation. A0 plus a1x plus a2x square is parabolic equation. So temperature distribution in the case of generation is always a parabola and the parabola is downward parabola. That is confirmed. So whenever we have a generation, we have a parabola. If there is no generation, we get d square t by dx square equal to 0 because q triple dash is 0. And if we integrate this term, we'll get dt by dx equal to some constant c1. If we integrate further, we'll get t equals to c1x plus c2. So we have linear distribution in the case of slab without heat generation and we have parabolic distribution with generation. So we'll consider here three different configurations. And your objective is to find out the value of C1 and C2. It entirely depends what is the boundary condition for you. So let's consider the first case where the current is passed exactly to the center of a plate. In second case, we'll make the offset. In the second case, we'll make the offset. The current is offset to the one side. So the position of temperature will shift. And in third scene, we'll keep the one end of the plate is insulated. When I say one plate, it means that actually five faces are insulated, that is top, bottom and one side. So whenever we have the distribution is parabolic and the current is passed through center, so we have a parabola here and both the walls are at same temperature. You take in reverse A. If you are given both wall temperatures are same, it means that a current will pass through center and maximum temperature will occur at center. If it is offset, it means that both wall temperatures are different because if we draw the parabola, then we have one temperature is TW1 and second temperature is TW2. And the apex of this parabola is shifted from where the current is passed. Apex is exactly at the center. In the third case, the surface is insulated, so all the time the heat will always transfer from the right face. No heat can go to the left side. So in this case, the heat transfer is towards right. It means that this is max value and your parabola is half missing. So we have a distribution of parabola, but half of the parabola is missing because in all these cases, your distribution must be parabolic. So whatever the temperature at this wall, TW1 and this is TW2. So in this case, TW will be same as T max. So for this figure, we know the position of maximum temperature. In this case, the maximum temperature will occur on the apex of a parabola. And this one is offset case. In this case, we have center and your temperature will exactly occur at center. So in case number 1 and case number 3, we are having Confirm location of maximum temperature. At this point our dT by dx is 0. At this point also our dT by dx is 0. So whenever we have maxima, we have dT by dx equal to 0. So all these values indicate dT by dx equal to 0. Now dT by dx equal to 0, and I will going to use, so I will assign the value of x equal to 0 if I know the position of maximum temperature, and other two side I will write plus L by 2 and minus L by 2. Because if I select this equation, my dT by dx is 0, and if I put my x equal to 0, my C1 will be 0. So therefore C1 will not appear in the another term, that is next term. If I put my condition like this, x equal to 0 and x equal to L by 2, the maximum temperature will occur at x equal to L by 2. So extra term of C1 will develop. If you do not want extra term of C1 to be developed, better put center x equal to 0. So prefer first condition then second condition. Your problem will solve very fast. Avoid this. So if you want a quick solution, use this result. That is x equal to 0 at center, C1 will vanish and only C2 will come in the picture. Now this logic you apply only to those cases where we are sure about the location of maximum temperature. In this figure we don't know the location, so don't apply this concept. So if we put x equal to 0, we'll get dt by dx equal to 0. So C1 will be 0, so this equation will reduce to t equal to minus q triple dash x square by twice k plus C2. C2 you can obtain by putting x equal to L by 2, or even you can put x equal to minus L by 2. But this is square term, so it will adjust, no issue. So finally we'll get tw plus q triple dash L square by 8k equal to C2. And your equation is ready. Now if you don't know the location of the maximum temperature, it is advised that you write on the left hand side. On the left face you should write x equal to 0, and on the right face you should write x equal to L. And then simply generate your boundary condition and use equation number 2 directly. So at x equal to 0, we have t is equal to tw1. So equation 1 implies this term, this will be equal to tw1. Since we are putting x equal to 0, this term is 0, as well as the second term of C1 is also equal to 0. So this value will be equal to C2 value. Your idea is to generate the value of C1 and C2 very fast. Then you can use the other right condition, that is x equal to L. This time t is equal to tw2. So go on substituting for this boundary condition in equation 2. We get tw2 equal to minus q triple dash L square twice k plus C1L. And C2 you can replace as tw2. Now you can solve for C1 and continue our problem. This is tw1. Solve this equation for C1 and you can generate your condition. Finally, we'll discuss the third case, that is insulated on one side. So in the third case, our boundary condition is on this side. We have a maxima at x equal to 0 and this is x equal to L. So at x equal to 0, we have dt by dx equal to 0 from equation number 1. X equal to 0, dt by dx is 0, so C1 must equal to 0. So always take the advantage of known position of maximum temperature. At x equal to 0, dt by dx is 0, so therefore C1 is 0. You can conclude it from equation 1. And then again you can find out the value of C2 from the right hand side. So we'll wind up this. Remember this equation, governing equation. Start your problem from this. Take two steps of integration. Identify the location of maximum temperature. If it is given, how you come to know that if both walls are temperatures are same, it means that a maximum will occur at center. So whenever in a problem we have given tw1 equal to tw2 is equal to same wall temperature, your maximum will occur at center. So assign center line value equal to 0, right and left face equal to plus minus L by 2. When we don't know, then assign x equal to 0 and x equal to L. This time tw1 is not equal to tw2, so solve by regular method. And in case of convection, in case of insulation, when one side is insulated, assign left hand side x equal to 0 and right hand side x equal to L. So whenever you have to find out maximum temperature, then only use the second order differential form.